We had a massive, massive game of the week. Silsbee, Hamshire-Fannett. You know, this has been a great rivalry over the years because both teams have been phenomenal. Both teams have been competing for a district championship. And, of course, you know, you flip the calendar 2024 this year. Everybody had it circled. First game, first district game of the year. Mm-hmm. How would things shake out?
Well, you know, a funny stat about that. Every team that has won Band of the Week this year has won the game of the week as well.
Ooh.
Is that trend going to continue, though?
It might.
We're going to find out. Let's get to it. The game of the week, Tigers and Longhorns, the one we've been waiting for all season. Let's get right to it. Longhorns with the ball, QB Ty Bryson. He's going to drop back and he's going to throw it over the middle, but it gets blown up by Silsbee Tiger Gary Farr. He's getting his wide receivers hurt. Take care of your guys. A little later, Longhorns in the red zone. Bryson throwing over the middle again. He finds TJ Larinette diving across your coffee table for the touchdown right there. Of course, the secret handshake. You got to celebrate. More Longhorns, though. Bryson, again, is going to roll out to his left and watch this pass right here. He is going to drop the biscuit in the basket. What a beautiful pass. What a beautiful catch. Braxton Starnes right there, 14-0 Hamshire-Fannett. Later in the half, Bryson drops back again. He's going to feel the pressure coming from the outside. He's going to move around and throw a dart to Pierce Pirtle, who turns up the juice, gets up the field, and lays out just over the goal line. 21-0 Longhorns. If this was Madden, the game would be over. One last play for Silsbee before the half. Mikey Moses is going to drop back, and he's going to give it the old heave-ho. Just air it out towards the end zone, hope for the best. It's almost picked off, but the ball would fall to the ground. Is the final in this one? It is the final. Hamshire-Fannett, 35-14. Longhorns improved to 5-1 overall, 1-0 in district play.
Wow. Hey, let's go out to Holton Pepper. He is live with head coach Mark Wagner of the Hamshire-Fannett Longhorns. I know coach has got to be fired up for this game.
Oh, you were absolutely correct. Coach is fired up. I was talking to him, and this is officially the first time that Hamshire-Fannett has beaten Silsbee under head coach Mark Wagner. I'm just going to go ahead and start, and just by asking you, coach, what are the emotions right now?
Well, you got the monkey off your back, right? I'm ecstatic. I told the kids I was so proud of them. I believe in them. I think they can do anything, and I think they know that now. I'm really happy, coach, right now.
I mean, there's not a whole lot that can be said about this team right now, except that they're just firing on all cylinders, and they're listening to the leadership that you are providing on this team. And there are several players that have stepped up on this team to really move this thing forward. And I did get my T-shirt finally. You can see it right here. They don't need no pitchy-pitchy woo-woo for this one. They didn't need that. This was an outstanding victory for these guys. Coach, just looking forward into the future, what is it going to take to continue to keep the foot on the pedal?
Well, I think tonight was the stepping stone. You know, the defensive performance tonight was very physical. They got a really high-scoring offense, as everybody knows, and we shut it down pretty much. And then offensively, I think we were very explosive all night. I think the second half we slowed it down just a little bit, but, you know, you have to when you're up and you want to run the clock a little bit. But I thought it was an outstanding performance through special teams, defense, offense. I think we got a pretty good football team.
This football team was able to keep the consistency in the second half, and I think that's what really stood out. They got out large in the first half, but they kept on the pace, and they made sure that second half went the way of the Hamshire-Fannett Longhorns. What can you say about the tenacity of your team?
Well, I think the tenacity is the reason we all have all these guys here tonight, because these are the guys that actually play, right? We want to sit up in that press box and let these guys play the game, because they're the ones that win and lose the game, right? And they did it on their own. They've earned it, and I said, hey, guys, it should be your interview tonight, not mine. So, yes.
Well, let's turn it around real quick. Since we're in Hamshire-Fannett, you know what we got to do. We got to go nuts! Go! 35-14 is your final score. Hamshire-Fannett wins this one big time. Fellas, I know you're going to come back to me later in the show. It's not going to be as good as this live shot, but take it away anyway. Either way.
Hey, where's that shirt at? Pitchy, pitchy, woo-woo.
Bring one back.
Bring two back here. Right. I need
that's
a large.
Pretty good. There it is. You think those guys.
Look at it. There it is right there.
There it is. Well done.
I love it. Hey, start selling it. Give it out to HFISD.
Right. You think those guys were a little excited about getting that win tonight?
Hey, monkey off their back, like Coach Wagner says. Mm-hmm. Man, I've known that guy for many, many years. He used to be the head coach at Waco Riker. So good to see him and his team rolling. That West Orange Storks Hamshire-Fannett game is going to be a class. That's going to be a championship there.
Say, a future game of the week.
Oh,
huh?
Yeah.